You're the rock star of the watch business. Are you worried they might rip your clothes off one day when you go to Bali, you know?
Some girls have started.
Really? Now I'm talking to collectors. What is F.P. Journet?
F.P. Journet, c'est François-Paul Journet, c'est mon nom.
F.P. Journet, it is François-Paul Journet. It is my name. I am of French origin and I live in Geneva and have studied clockmaking since I was 14 years of age.
J'ai commencé ma carrière en fabriquant des...
I began my career repairing old clocks, but shortly after, I began to manufacture watches for collectors. This was the beginning of the 80s. These watches were of unique design and precision built for the individual customer requirements. From 1994, I began to design a new collection aimed at a more broader market. This collection has taken me 6 years to develop, because in my philosophy as a professional watchmaker, I make everything. The movement, the mechanism is entirely made here in our workshop and assembled. Each watchmaker makes his watch piece by piece entirely.
Why watches? Why movements?
Non, je suis arrivé à l'école d'horlogerie.
I came to watchmaker school by chance. And when I began watchmaking, it became a passion immediately. And this passion is still in me. This spirit makes me want to sublime the art of watchmaking.
À 17 ans, quand j'ai travaillé chez mon oncle dans l'horlogerie ancienne et que j'ai commencé à toucher.
At 17, when I was working in my uncle's workshop on antique watches, I was working on watches from the 16th, 17th, and 18th centuries. All the richness of the watchmaker's art at this time was extraordinary, because watchmaking was an avant-garde science and there was an array of incredibly creative people involved. And I was being introduced to the biggest collectors.
George Daniels from, of course, who did the escapement
for Amiga. It's a friend. 20 ans.
From 20 years.
La mécanique d'une montre est entourée de contraintes. La première contrainte...
The mechanic of a watch has a lot of limitations. The first one is the volume for a wristwatch. The second limitation is the function. It must be a functional and useful object.
Qui ne peut pas sortir d'une contrainte utilitaire.
From there on, the more artistic part is the development, the design, and all the aesthetics. One can design a movement in 10,000 different ways. One can design a face in 10,000 different ways. The art of the watchmaker is balancing the aesthetic within the mechanical constraints.
Look like this?
Because my name is Jean-Paul Journet.
What is the logic?
La volonté d'esthétique sur mes montres, c'est premièrement la dureté des obligations mécaniques me force.
The aesthetics of my watches have a direct cause. The reality of the mechanical constraints obliges me to express the soul of what is inside.
Que chaque montre que je fais qui porte ma signature, il y a un cahier des charges.
For each watch that bears my name, my signature, there is one obligation: that I always produce something that does not exist yet, otherwise I'm not interested.
How many do you produce every year?
600-700 pièces pour le monde.
Ça, c'est de l'équilibre.
600-700 for the whole world. Our workshop now has 30 people.
When you first showed this watch to the industry, it must have been a big reaction.
Quand j'ai présenté les montres pour la première fois à Bâle,
the first year I presented my collection in Basel, there was just two watches in my collection.
À la foire de Bâle, la première année, j'étais dans une.
I showed at the Independent Watchmaker Academy. And all the important people from the watchmakers industry came by. And in a few days, I met all the important distributors from the whole world. My head was spinning. A friend advised me, don't promise anything to anybody. Don't sign any contracts, wait for the end of the fair and think about their proposals.
What is your influence for the look?
Tradition horlogère, surtout le.
Traditional watchmaking, especially the 18th century, marine chronometers.
Il n'y a plus de séparation entre le mouvement et le cadran.
Normally in a watch, there is a mechanism, and then you dress it up. The face has no relation with the mechanism. What I want to achieve is that when somebody looks at my watches, they will know what's inside just by looking at the face of the watch. The mechanism and the aesthetic have been constructed in parallel. The watch is holistically true.
But then why in the movement here it says made in China in here?
Really?
Ah, he speaks English!